So today I want to show you how I do 60 seconds, 30 seconds, and 15 second edits of my main track. Now, why would we want to do this? Well, the reason why is that there's a lot of commercials and advertisement which have like a standard length. And you know, it's very important for us as composers and media composers to get into the habit, if you're not already doing it, to do this kind of edits, because what you're doing is you are offering even more value to the broadcasters, to the broadcast company, or to the video editors, to the video makers as well. And this comes in very handy. Now, what this does is that you have your main track, okay, which could be in length of a minute and a half or 2 minutes or 2.5 minutes, if that's the amount of time that you need in order to express your musical idea. And what you do is that you reduce that to a 60-second, 1 minute version of that track, of the main idea. Now, you can do this in two ways. You can edit when you have your project open, like I do right now. I have my main project open, which means I have all the elements of the song. It's already been mixed and everything, and I do the edits there in my project section. But you can also do that after the mastering has done, meaning that you have the final product, the WAV file or whatever, and you actually do those edits as well with that. I've done both of them, and the easiest way to do this is to have your main project session. Do it with your main project when you have already mixed your song, okay? Some companies, they will do these edits anyways. Yeah, they might buy the original track, which is like a minute and a half, and they will do those edits as well. There's actually people that do this, and they can do this with the final product, no problem. And they just, you know, it's just literally like cutting one piece and putting them together, and it will make sense as a whole. So I just want to show you how I have it lay out in my actual session so you can see what I mean by that. Okay, so here we are, and I just want to show you very quickly what I have on my... How do I have divided all of this, pretty much? So here you have the full version, have the 60 version and the 30 version. And here I have the 15 version. I have a sting and a loop, which we'll get into it later on. I just want to focus and concentrate on 60 second edits, the 30 second edits, and the 15 second edits. So what I want you to listen to is to the actual track and see how do I edit and do this kind of edits, really. So let's hear the full version. Just a classic pop rock track. So what we do here is when I go to my set by my first edit, which will be the 60 second edit, and like I said before, try to start it on an actual even number. This is I believe is in minute 2 over here, so I can calculate exactly when is it going to finish. So it should finish on minute 3, which is 60 seconds. So you will notice that it will go straight into the actual melody, and it will go more straight to the point. It will still include the certain elements of the main mix, but it will be much more compressed, if you say. Compressed, I mean in time, and a little bit more shorter. So pretty much what it does is it just goes straight to the point. It doesn't have an intro. The drums kick in immediately. And the endings are usually, the beginning of the actual edit and the ending is usually what's very important. In this case, if you notice here, let's play again the main track, the ending. So that's the main track, that's the ending. And this is the ending of the actual 60-second edit. Now the endings and the beginnings are usually is the thing that you're gonna be focusing on, because you wanna start in a way that it makes sense, and whatever's in between in the middle part of the actual track or the edit should make sense in terms of the actual edit itself. So because we have less time, we have to really concentrate and think how we're gonna start this edit, this piece of music, and how we're gonna include as well the certain elements that have changed of the original track and the actual edit, so it could make some kind of sense. So if I play you now the 30-second edit over here, it's even it's much smaller time to tell this little story or tell this this sound, this track, you know. So here it goes. If you listen to it, it's actually, the main idea is still there. It's the same track. It has the same kind of like vibe, the same flavor. And really, it just goes straight to the point. And there's like a peak, and then there's a release immediately. So now, if I go to the 15-second, this should be a little bit more interested. Again, it's the same musical idea. It's just smaller and smaller, and it gets smaller and smaller and smaller. So a little bit of a variation there with the drums, a little bit of just to create a little bit more of excitement, really. So that's the way you do the edits. What you should focus on is the intro, and it's almost like playing Lego with your music. You know, I have bars. If you see the music is pretty, I almost have like divisions in terms of bars somehow, you know. But you can do that edit yourself as well in your DAW, and then you can just, you know, it's literally like putting pieces together and see if they can make sense somehow. I want to play for you now, since we're here, let me play you the Sting version of it, and yet again a smaller compressed version of the track so you can get an idea. Even smaller version. So that's just a little bonus that I wanted to. And it's tons of fun. Once you start doing this, it could be very, very fun. It could be something that you can, you will start wearing a different hat. So you're not making the music anymore. You're not just the actual composer. You're actually now editing. And funny enough, you start to listen to your music in a different way because you're so focused on the actual arrangement and the actual editing element of it that really you just like withdraw yourself from the mixing process and the actual mastering process. So this is in the mixing stage. This is already mixed, but I do this on the actual project so I can manipulate a little bit better the actual elements. And then I will obviously bounce each single one of them. I will then master it. I will master all the actual project, but then obviously I will master it. And that's just a very basic process, really. My best advice is just to start practicing with this and have loads of fun. it's just one of those things. It's a very good way to increase your file count. And if you're gonna upload these files to different libraries, you know, you can very quickly increase your portfolio. It's just a skill that you should have under your belt for sure. And the best way to do this is to just get busy doing them. So compose your main track, your main idea. Just feel free to actually have a main track without even worrying about how you're gonna edit that later on. So I usually start in that order, 60 second, and then I start to trim down even more as I go along. So yeah, man, you know, it's one of those things, really. It's just a matter of having fun with it, for sure. It's a lot of fun for me. It's a little bit of work. It takes work. I'm not going to lie, but it's a lot of fun. You know, I highly recommend to do it in all kinds of style of music, whatever you're doing, and get into the habit of doing edits for your songs, 60, 30 seconds, and 15 seconds. And yeah, man, hope these videos, you find them helpful. I've been meaning to do one of these for some time now. And yeah, man, just leave the comments below. What's your take on this kind of videos with concerning edits for stock music? And as always, man, thanks for the love and support, and rock and roll, man. See you on the other side of success.